I'm Kirsten. I'm 38 years old, and I'm what you, I think, you call a social mother. I'm not the birth mother. And this is Elliot, and he's 18 months old.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm Merete, and I'm the birth mother, and we have been together for
nearly 8 years.
Thank you.
Yes. And we've had we got Elliot in Norway, and he has what's called an open donor. So he's he gets to know who his donor is when he's 18 years old, if he wants to.
Yeah. Shall I do it for both of us? Yeah, he's Adam, my name is Christian, and these are our kids, Eric and David. They are originally from Hungary, but about 1.5 years ago we moved to Oslo, and now we live in Norway. We've been together for I think 8 or 9 years, and the kids are 8 years, and he's turning 5 soon, and he's turning 2 soon.
Hi, my name is Mona. I've been in the board of Rainbow Families for 22 years. And I have, this is my family, and this is my family. I have painted this picture. This is maybe I'm not a great artist, but I think this might be me. This is my ex-girlfriend. We still live together. This is the dads of the children. This is one child. I have 2 children. It's Line, who is almost 18, and Sarah, who is almost 15. This is Sarah. This is the cat that disappeared. This is the dog that haven't disappeared. His name, her name is Garbo. And it's this is the same without the. My daughter has painted this picture. Sarah, when she was 12. This is her and her sister. This is the dad, and this these are the moms, I guess. Maybe I'm the happy one, or I don't know. So, yes.
He gets up very early and he goes with me. I work at the hospital, one of the hospitals in town, and he comes on the bus with me. And he has a kindergarten at the hospital. So I put him there in the morning, and then I collect him in the afternoon. And then we play on the way home, and then we eat dinner and he goes to bed. That's
about it. That's
quite
a normal daily life.
Yeah.
Okay.
And in the weekends we meet people. Yeah,
we
often have visitors
at the end. Say bye. Make you get up in the morning, get our kids to school, come home from work, make dinner, put our kids to bed, go and watch television. Very exciting. It's like
actually no. Honestly, here we have absolutely no problem in Oslo. I think that the whole system is very open for Rainbow Family.
Not really.
I don't think in our everyday life that we do. But that's also because we have many friends in the same situation, and also friends that are very
open-minded.
Yeah. And they doesn't. Yeah, they don't care how we. they're very supportive of our situation, and also our parents and families are open and think it's no problem. And I think it was only in the very beginning when we were together with your parents that it could have been.
Yeah, I think they found it was a bit I think my mother had difficulties telling her friends that we were together in the beginning, but then after a while, they live in a road where on the other side of the road there's 2 gay men that live, so they kind of, they've got to know more and more people that have gay children, and they're kind of, so it kind of just worked itself out really.
No, what could I do?
That's not, I don't think, I mean, people, some people are kind of like, oh, if you're, if you've got gay parents, you'll be gay as well, and I don't think that's right at all, so I don't think it's a threat to anyone.
Okay. Okay. Maybe you're gay or lesbian, but you're still very... two moms, two dads, you're so... We are just as boring as everyone else.
I don't even get... From the argument's sake, I don't even get their point. Like, what do they mean by that? Like, if I move to a new neighborhood where I'm going to have a nuclear family as my neighbors, and they see me one day, and they look at me, and suddenly one of them is going to realize that I'm going to get divorced, I'm going to kill my kids because my neighbors are same-sex parents. So I don't get the link. What's the link between that? How am I going to ruin their image? How am I going to ruin their everyday life? They love for each other, they commitment for each other.
Okay. I don't know what's so exciting about that. We live really traditional lives, just coping with our work and trying to get enough sleep.
My original profession is a family therapist and a psychologist, and because of that I also know that maybe not only because of that, but I think it's an open fact that families, as we claim they are traditional, it's only like 100-150 years old. Before that, these type of families did not exist in this way.
Which kind of family?
One parent from one gender, another parent from other gender, and having in average 2.1 or 1.9, depending on the country, kids living under the same roof and paying frequent visits to grandparents on the weekends. This is a very new phenomenon in our life, and I don't think that it has been so disastrous in the past few centuries when we didn't have this type of family type, and I'm not a big believer that it's going to ruin our world.
Mm-hmm.
If we go back to one direction, I really believe that if you look back 300 years, and if you look back 1,000 years, you will find many different type of well-functioning families, which could provide safety and love and acceptance to kids. And I think that this is what's important, and it has not really that much to do with gender of parents and how many parents you have.
Mm-hmm, okay. That's a very difficult question, but it's like I think they are more accepting, and I think that showing that we are gays and lesbians, if the heterosexual people often get the gay children, they are the ones that get that give birth to most gay children. As heterosexuals. So it's not a tragedy getting a gay or lesbian child. Many people are very, they are hoping that they will get grandchildren, and if you have gay children before, you didn't get grandchildren, so it was like a small tragedy for someone, for some. And now it's not, this is not a problem anymore, so the heterosexual noise. You can even get grandchildren if you have gay family.
Thanks to the work that has been done by organizations like LLH and other activists. Yeah, I think that has a lot to do with it. And that we got the can you stop the
mic,
please? we got the, what do you call it? Same-sex marriage. Some years back,
yeah.
And I think that's it's a part of why it's been easier.
I think that we are visible to create an arena where there are visible families, people that are role models. Maybe we were role models, or we were role models for those coming after us.
Mm.
And I also think that we were in, like when I was young, like young, 20, 18, 19, 20, it was we were more politically aware. It was, we didn't have the partnership law. It was more discrimination. It was more official discrimination. So we were more used to be visible, to be, to not be at war, to face more problems. And then we were also in the media, talking about our families. And I think it's visibility and visibility and visibility and visibility. Okay. So it's, yeah, and to create an arena where people meet. So it's there, it's a safe arena.
What would you say to gay couples and lesbian couples in Poland who want to have children? What's your...
Just do it. Just do it. It's actually enriching your lives and...
Well, just go for it and stay together as a group. You will probably gain more confidence and stand up for your rights against the rest of the society.
Based on our experience, I think it takes a lot of courage and commitment to go through and find your ways, but I also know that it is really, really worth all the effort and all the commitment or all the sacrifice that you had to make along the way. It is really worth it. So just stay strong and do what your heart tells you to do.